In this illustration, we'll discuss about a stone hitting a flying bird. This is a case on which various problems are framed in different situations. Here we are given that a stone is projected from a point on ground in such a direction so as to hit a bird on top of a tower of height H. But at the instant of projection, bird flies off in horizontal direction with uniform speed. And it is saying the stone further reaches a maximum height of 3H/2 and hits the bird in onward journey. And we are required to find the ratio of horizontal velocities of bird and stone. Here in solution, if we first draw the picture, here we can see on ground there is a tower of height H on which there is a bird. And from ground, say with an initial speed u at an angle theta, a stone is thrown. And just before hitting the bird flies off in horizontal direction. And the stone goes up, reaches maximum height, and in onward journey, it finally hits the bird over here. This is the situation. Now, it is also given that the maximum height attained by the stone is 3H/2. Now, in this situation, we are required to find the ratio of horizontal velocities of bird and stone. Here, for a stone, we can use the equation of trajectory is y is x tan theta minus gx square by 2u square cos square theta. Here, we can see if this tower is at a distance x1, from the projection point, say this point is A, and the another point where the stone is hitting the bird is say located at a distance x2. Then in this situation, we can say both x1, x2 and h will satisfy this equation. So here we can write y is equals to h, that is equals to x tan theta minus gx square by 2u square cos square theta. You can see there's a quadratic equation in x, so the two roots of x will be x1 and x2, where the value of y is h. Here, if we further simplify this quadratic equation, you can see this will be written as x square minus, here, if we substitute the values of u, we can see as the maximum height attained by the projectile is 3H/2, here we can write u square sine square theta by 2g can be written as 3H/2. So here the value of u can be given as, or u square by g can be written as 3H/sine² θ. So here the value of u square by g we can substitute. So this will become x square minus 6HX cot θ. I've already simplified this expression. So, I'm getting this as 6H² cot²θ. This is after simplification we'll get. And if we solve this quadratic, the value of x we are getting is minus b 6H cot θ plus minus root of, here b square will be, in this situation it is 36H² cot²θ minus 4 times this is 24, 36 minus 24 is 12, H² cot²θ divided by 2. So, the value of x we are getting is, the two roots we are getting is x1 and x2, which are, this will be 3 plus minus this 2 root 3, so this is root 3. So here we can write x1 as 3 minus root 3 H cot θ, and the value of x2 is equals to 3 plus root 3 H cot θ. So these two values of x1 and x2 we are getting. And say if we talk about the projection time here, we are given that the bird at the instant of projection flies off in horizontal direction. That means if at t equals to 0, bird flies off as well as the stone is projected. So in time t, if the time elapsed up to the time of hitting is t, then in this time the stone has traveled a distance x2 and the bird has traveled a distance x2 minus x1. So here we can write in this situation, the value of u cos theta, which is the stone velocity multiplied by time, should be equals to x2. And if bud velocity is v, we can write v multiplied by t is equals to x2 minus x1. So, in this equation, if we calculate the ratio from this equation 1 and 2, we can see the ratio which we are required to find is v by u cos theta, and the value will be x2 minus x1 by x2. And if you substitute the values, this will give you 2 root 3 divided by 3 plus root 3, that will be the final result of this problem.